morning friends, and welcome to the pre-market session. We had a lot of weakness right from the word go as far as European markets go, and actually that caused a lot of nervousness in our market also, and in the US markets also. When it started, European markets were down about 2-3%, and US markets were also down about 1-odd%. The major concern was that the data that came out from Europe, particularly on the manufacturing sector, were weak. Also, there are some political issues in some of the countries like France and Netherlands, which are going in for elections. And overall, there is uncertainty about what kind of response some of these bond auctions will get once they are there. And we know that over the next couple of days, you know, two or three big bond auctions are lined up, and the overall yield as far as pain is concerned is about 6%. So we will have to watch how they go and how the European markets open up today for trading. Asian markets are slightly positive, particularly Hang Seng and Nikkei, and even SGX is suggesting that we are going to have a gap up opening to the tune of about 40 odd points at around 50-30 odd levels after a sharp cut yesterday. As far as flows go, friends, in the cash market, FI sold to the tune of about 415 odd crore, but domestic institutions were buyers to the tune of 440 crore. On that note, let me invite Shaival to take us through the F&O, please. Good morning, Shaival. We've seen major weakness in the market yesterday, and the key levels where, you know, people were hoping that there would be some support, 5300, that has been taken out very comprehensively. So looking at the overall open interest and the IVs, what is the outlook?
See, first of all, I'd like to bring to your notice two to three things. First of all, we have seen that FIs have been net sellers in the futures and options segment from past couple of trading session, and even in yesterday's trading session, they were net seller by 110 crore. Now, if we have a look at the rollover on the first week of the, if we have a look at the rollover of the Nifty as well as Bank Nifty on the first day of the expiry week, Nifty stands with rollover of around 27.44%, whereas Bank Nifty stands with rollover of 14.915%. If we compare it to the first day of last expiry week, then this is pretty lower compared to the previous expiry. Now, there is one reason, this might be one of the reasons why the volumes in the markets are very low. We have seen that the volumes have been shrinking in past couple of days, and this is also indicating that FIs have been very reluctant on the issues which have been going domestically and as well as the politically. Also, what we have seen that the open interest in Nifty has traded below the mark of 2 lakh crore shares, and it has bounced back sharply, but we have not seen a major addition on the futures and options front in Nifty. We have seen short positions have been accumulated in yesterday's trade about 5300, and from there we have seen that the markets have been continuously sliding. So as you said, the implied volatility was continuously cooling off from past couple of trading session, and we have seen a sharp up move from yesterday's low, and we have seen concentration in 5100 as well as 5100 put option on the open interest front, whereas on the call front, 5200, 300 and 400 has seen a good activity in terms of open interest. So what we feel is that 5100 on closing basis for the market in the near term would act as a good support, whereas on the higher side, we feel that expiry would take somewhere between 5250-5300 in the April series. It may be plus or minus 20 or 30 points on the either side.
Right, so any specific strategy that we can recommend to customers?
See, as of now, we are not having any specific strategy, but if there would be any strategy, we would be surely forwarding it to you and we would bring to your notice. But yes, from the intraday perspective, if one want to trade in the market, then we have three stocks on basis of derivative data. One is financial technology. We have negative bias on that with resistance of 737.40 rupees, Biocon with resistance of 240.50 rupees, and Kane India with resistance of 346 rupees.
Thanks a lot, Shaival, for that update.
Thank you.
Friends, in terms of news, TCS came out with a good set of numbers, and they were much better than the market expectations, and particularly in the backdrop of the Infosys' poor performance and the guidance. The TCS outlook for next year was much more positive. The body language of the management was much better. So there is going to be a positive reaction to these numbers. We've already rolled out a nice quarterly result strategy, and one can really play on to this TCS numbers, you know, with those levels. Also, friends, in terms of other news, telecom stocks were sharply down yesterday after the news that the TRAI has recommended a much higher auction price for the 2G. And though these are the recommendations, the final decision is to be taken by the government of India. But since the overall recommendations are much, much higher, there was a negative reaction by most of the telecom companies like Bharti, Idea, Arcom. So there might be some more negative sentiment for the stock. Also, friends, in case of Infosys, we had seen that the stock was down almost 3.5-4%, and the delivery volume on the stock was on a much higher side. The key level in terms of support is around 2270 or thereabouts. So people who want to play for a pullback or somebody who wants to accumulate for a slightly medium term perspective can look at entering in this zone, because we've seen that the rupee has come down to 52.50. So this could be some kind of a positive news for Infosys. Also, in terms of other news, China has okayed the import of rice from India. So some of the smaller companies like KRBL and Lakshmi Overseas could remain in action on the back of that. Also, United Phosphorus, friends, there are news that CCI has penalized United Phosphorus to the tune of 252 crore for manipulation in the prices. We've seen that United Phosphorus was already down to about 128, and 124, 125 is an important demand zone. So though this news are negative, we believe that the stock may not react as it has already gone down. Also, friends, Maruti, there are reports that it has increased the dealer discount for the petrol car by about 5-10%, because you know, because of the higher petrol prices, they are losing market share. And also there are reports that the workers at Manesar plant have asked for a hike in the wages to the tune of about 5 times. So and we have seen that Maruti stock has actually run up in the past 1 month or so. So this could be a bit of a negative news for Maruti, and there might be some kind of a reaction today to start with. That's it from all of us, friends. Have a nice trading session. See you tomorrow at the same time.